Welcome to Spiritual Awakening Family. Greetings, my beautiful beings of light. The swirling energies are engulfing you and pulling you this way and that. Of course, the chaos is always there and will be with you for quite some time. There may still be some dark personal moments as you continue to cycle on and off, for you are doing all that clearing and releasing from your vast energy fields from eons of time. My beloveds, you might want to label this the new norm for now, because my beautiful beings of light, you will be clearing the debris from all the nooks and crannies for the next several decades to come. It would have been lovely to have just flipped a switch, so it were, and there would be a golden age of pure love, but that is not how your pre-incarnated contracts cast this time, in these moments in now. Mass consciousness, my beloveds, didn't see it this way, and so it is written. My divine beings of grace, as you know or are remembering, time really only exists on the earth plane. Linear time, as you know it, is actually dissolving. In celestial viewing, these moments pass through in the blink of an eye. Perhaps repeating this mantra will help you keep the tough chaotic moments in perspective. Even this shall pass away, even this shall pass away, even this shall pass away. Ask your angels and guides to help you walk through these moments with ease and grace. One of the challenges of this moment is identifying whether you are resisting your personal spiritual guidance or pushing the envelope to expand your personal growth. Both of the choices have a pause involved when you are right there next to them in action. My beloveds, ask yourselves this question: are you feeling like you are waiting constantly on information or for a desired project to come to completion? Each time you keep anticipating the information or results to be completed, a new shoe drops, extending the delays. It just seems like one thing right after the other comes up and stops the progress, or adds a new hurdle to be jumped through. When you encounter this scenario, my beautiful light beings of grace, this is resistance. There has been some shortfall of understood spiritual inner guidance, direction, or frequency level that has not been heard or acknowledged or achieved on your part. These are areas or projects that were not lined up for your highest and best outcomes or aligned with your higher master blueprint. These were expectations and outcomes that were created from your own conscious limitations or views, thereby, were not in sync with your own higher divine blueprint. Resistance is like being smacked in the face over and over and over again. The sad part is, my beautiful beings of light, that the more you expend the effort and persist in this direction, the more your own personal guidance and higher wisdom will put larger and larger stumbling blocks in your way, trying to avert you from erring in the wrong direction. This can be very painful, to say the least, my beloveds. When you find yourself in this endless loop, take a deep breath. Close your eyes and ask, what is it that is being missed? There is always something that is missing from this scenario. It may just be a step to ask someone for help, or it could be much deeper and a need to actually evaluate whether this project should be scrapped and dismissed completely. Go inside and check in with your inner guidance and higher wisdom, then follow through on what you are being instructed to do. Make a note to yourself, however, that sometimes your own mental ego self voice may need to be filtered out of the inner guidance you are receiving. The ego self can sabotage the best of intentions. If you still see yourself having difficulty after difficulty, you may in fact have received ego, conscious mind, chatter versus true inner guidance. There is a need to learn to distinguish between the two, my beloveds, for they have very different outcomes. My divine beings of grace, when you are pushing the envelope or expanding, you will find that the steps, information, and processes will be lined up perfectly, and that each one will fall into place with ease and grace. The steps or information may not all appear at one time, but you will find that you are not struggling to make something happen. You are not tied up with some preconceived expectation of the outcome. These are divinely guided moments and are part of your very own benevolent outcome, which has been put into place for your expansion, success, and growth. Allow this messenger to take you on a mediation journey. Sit in a chair or lie down, whichever is your preference. It's time to be comfortable and undisturbed for a while as you journey within yourself through meditation. Close your eyes and take a few deep breaths in and out. Visualize with each in-breath, you are breathing in love and renewal. With each out-breath, you are breathing out pain, fear, frustrations, and doubts. With the last out-breath, feel your body relaxing. Allow and give yourself permission to feel the calm, peace, and serenity of this safe place. My beloveds, ask your ego self to perch on your left shoulder. Instruct your ego self that it is only to be an observer on this journey, it is not to participate. Through prayer to the Creator, please ask the Creator to share with you a translucent golden shield of light. Visualize it all around you, forming a bubble from head to toe, protecting you from all outside influences and giving you warmth, radiance, light, and power. Negatives will simply bounce harmlessly off your shield of protective light. My beloveds, the Creator has responded to your prayer. Your protective bubble has been supplied. The energies for this bubble will continue to flow from the Creator, cycling back down through you again, and back to the Creator in a continuous circular loop while you are in meditation. You are now divinely protected at this moment, and nothing can even communicate with you that is not for your highest good, without your permission. Breathe in deeply, my beautiful beings of light, and sense the lighter, relaxed feelings of being divinely protected and guided into this meditation. Breathe in deeply and know that you are breathing to the pulse of the Creator. Breathe in deeply, allowing, seeing, and sensing within your spiritual imagination your guardian angels and invited spirit guides as they join you now. The angels take your spiritual etheric essence hands and guide you out of your physical body. The angels then direct you into your etheric spiritual heart chakra. An angel is staying with your physical essence until you return from your meditation journey. My beloveds, you are visualizing, seeing, feeling and sensing this within your imagination. Your guardian angels, spirit guides and special invited guests are with you now within your spiritual heart chakra. Your angels and guides are helping you locate the golden door that says to my highest guidance within. In your imagination you have located the golden door, and now you turn the etheric spiritual doorknob, opening the door as you cross over the threshold, knowing that you are on a spiritual growth adventure. You find yourself in a white marble corridor. Your angels hand you a set of goggles, an aviator hat and scarf. You put them on and immediately have a visual comic glimpse of yourself as Snoopy in the Peanuts carton, being the flying ace in his imagination. You laugh at yourself and your angels, perceiving your thought pictures, are just roaring with laughter. They do tell you that this exercise today won't be a comical one, but that they do enjoy the character of Snoopy. Your angels guide you down the hall to a door on your left. The door is labeled Wind Tunnel. You open the door, cross over the threshold and stand at awe, looking directly into this large hangar-like room complete with small airplane and this huge wind tunnel. The wind tunnel is painted bright yellow inside. Parked next to the wind tunnel is a small airplane that is sky blue in color, and it has beautiful angel wing artwork painted on the two airplane's wings. The front of the airplane has this lovely smile painted on it, and then two eyes are painted above it with the propeller looking like part of the nose. One of the angels relays that the airplane's name is Marvin. You walk over and touch Marvin's airplane wings where the angel wings are scrolled. Marvin startles you by telling you that your touch tickles. Smiling, you walk around the plane and look into Marvin's face. There Marvin greets you and asks if you are ready to take a ride. You nod your head and Marvin instructs the angels to bring you a ladder to climb into the cockpit. Before you start up the steps, an angel asks you to remove your hat for a moment and touches the center back part of your head, right where the hair ends and the neck begins. The angel tells you that they are flipping the switch to off on your inner guidance system for the moment. They want it turned off for the first part of the wind tunnel experience. You notice that the airplane has a second cockpit seat behind the first, and an angel pilot climbs into that second cockpit seat. The angel pilot removes the glass that separates the front seat from the rear seat. The angel pilot tells you that in a while they will need to flip that intuitive switch back to on, so the access to do that quickly is needed. Marvin sees that both of you are on board and starts the engine as the propeller begins to twirl round and round. Then Marvin asks you to put forth an intention to fly to the end of the wind tunnel in 15 seconds flat. You think to yourself that is a bit off, but do as Marvin has requested. After all, Marvin must know what he can do, or so you tell yourself. Marvin begins to taxi into place and then begins to roll down the airstrip within the wind tunnel. Marvin, however, doesn't seem to be getting anywhere, and you hear Marvin's engine revving higher and higher as he tries to take off down the field to accomplish that feat. This is rather worrisome as Marvin seems to be straining and working very hard without making much headway. Finally, Marvin gets off the ground in the wind tunnel, but you notice that the wind currents are making it extremely hard for Marvin to fly. This poor airplane, you tell yourself, just isn't going to be able to accomplish that expectation. You tell Marvin your concerns, and Marvin huffs and puffs and agrees with you. You ask Marvin to turn around and head back and land. Marvin agrees, however, you notice that Marvin really isn't making any progress in this wind, and it seems to actually be holding him in a standstill type position. You try checking in with yourself, but your inner guidance system is silent. You forgot that the angel turned it off before you climbed aboard. Your ego self, however, chimes in and is very vocal. It tells you that no, Marvin is doing just fine. It is just an old plane that isn't really able to keep up with that request. You find yourself not really buying what your ego self has to share, and you tell that to your ego self. Of course, the ego self then gets huffy and starts arguing with you. All this time, however, poor Marvin is becoming more and more fatigued. You really feel for this little airplane and tell Marvin that this simply isn't going to work. You ask Marvin to land right where he is. Marvin does as requested and lands right where he is. He thanks you for your consideration and compassion. It suddenly dawns on you that the ego self is all about resistance, judgment, criticism, and negative self-talk. You really grasp that realization when you journey back into your memory for a moment and there look at several episodes in your life, where you thought you were on the right intuitive forward track. The one thing that you realize now was that you were listening to that ego voice and it was directing you down the wrong highway with expectations that could never be met. You remember those very hard lessons and all the pitfalls trying to bring those projects or areas into completion. Some of those experiences took years of releasing just to bring you back into balance and put you back on the right intuitive road. As the AHA moment crystallizes for you, the recognition and remembrance really settle in on the remembrance of the ego self's voice pattern. This exercise with Marvin has made it very clear what your ego self's voice sounds like again. Your angel tells you good job for remembering that identification. This exercise will help you distinguish that voice much more quickly next time you hear it. Now that you remember that ego self's voice pattern, your angel says it is time for you to reconnect with your intuitive inner voice and guidance system. Marvin has been taking this moment to catch his breath. Your angel sitting behind you in the cockpit leans over from the back seat and quickly flips the intuition switch to on. The angel asks you to ask your intuitive inner voice to now speak to you, so that you can identify its voice pattern as well. Your inner guidance system relays that it is very glad to be turned back on, and yes, Marvin can very much accomplish all kinds of tasks under the right conditions and without the limiting timeline that stopped Marvin's progress to begin with. Your inner guidance system explains that the feat Marvin wanted to accomplish wasn't within the right frequency range for his highest good. Marvin had placed unrealistic expectations and guidelines upon himself because he was listening to the wrong guidance channel. Your guidance is asking that you have Marvin taxi down to the other end of the wind tunnel. Marvin follows your directions. Your inner guidance system tells you to have Marvin remove all expectations and limitations from his mission. You relay this to Marvin and Marvin agrees. When Marvin is in place at the other end, you have him begin his takeoff. Marvin instantly achieves liftoff without all those limitations. He is being divinely assisted with the wind currents blowing in just the right direction. This time Marvin is happy, having absolutely no difficulties, progressing with ease and grace on his journey to the other end of the wind tunnel. He even does a loop-de-loop in excitement and starts flying back to the other end and back again. The little airplane is having such a great time that he really doesn't want to stop flying. Your inner guidance system tells you that Marvin's mission has been accomplished and it is time to ask Marvin to land. Marvin comes in for a landing and experiences such ease and grace with his touchdown. As Marvin taxis to a stop, he thanks you for offering the correct inner guidance and allowing him the opportunity to expand his capabilities. Never before had Marvin been able to do a loop-de-loop. It was a pleasant expanding experience for Marvin. He held no expectations for an outcome and set no limiting boundaries on his own performance. The other angels are rolling up the stair ladder as you and your angel pilot gladly climb down from the cockpit. You walk around to Marvin's face and thank him for allowing you to have this experience with him. You explain to him that now you can distinguish the difference between resistance and really pushing the envelope. You have also remembered the voice patterns between your ego self and your own inner guidance system. Marvin smiles and tells you to come fly with him anytime you like. You smile back and tell him goodbye for the moment. Your angels quickly guide you back. You instantly find yourself back in the white marble corridor. You catch a glimpse of your glowing essence in the mirror. Your angels lead you back across the threshold of the golden door within, back into your spiritual heart chakra, and then they assist the return of your spiritual essence back into your physical form. Take a deep breath to help you reorient as you wiggle your fingers and toes. When you are ready, open your eyes. Go about your day remembering that your inner higher wisdom and angelic support staff are always at your service, working with you to help you reach your highest, most appropriate potential. Listen for those first thoughts that pop into your awareness and know without a shadow of a doubt that you are receiving daily spiritual guidance. Beloveds, you are blessed beyond words and loved beyond measure, more than any earth plane language can ever express. I am Archangel Michael, the Creator's messenger of love, joy, wisdom, light, peace, and grace. I hope you liked the video. Welcome to your channel. Don't forget to check out the other uploads.